Hello?
Halo, halo. Halo, halo. Majonez. O, słychać. Dzień dobry. Słuchajcie, to jest bardzo proste robić
It's very simple to
takie warsztaty,
make such workshops like
jak
Film Spring Open.
Receptę,
I will
ja
sell
robię.
You a good recipe.
Otóż
how do
ja
I do it? I invite especially my friends.
A po drugie,
and secondly, I invite those friends who have something to say, which I don't know.
Ja tak naprawdę,
so in a way,
I do the
Film Spring Open for myself. I sit here, I listen, and learn, and for the next year I have enough knowledge to come up with another idea with Film Spring Open. And because my friends develop during that time and they make a lot of experiments and new films, I invite them next year. And Dorota and Artur are here with us for the fifth time or sixth time, I lost count. I don't know if they remember.
No i tym razem pokazują projekt.
And this time they show you their unfinished project, which I believe is also interesting, because it's also good to show how it works behind the scenes, how things look in the midstream, or how can you talk about certain idea which is unfinished. It happens so that in our festival we've got quite often we talk about action scenes and how to make them.
So
at the level we do have this at the level of internet producers, creators. Randall is one of the experts in that.
Bardzo osobnego artysty, jakim jest Stanisław Onderek.
Stanisław Onderek, who is a very individual artist who's been for many years doing
Star Wars.
Star Wars in inverted commas. Arthur Combs, he's a number one in terms of special effects in films, double recipient of Oscar. He's got four nominations and four BAFTAs. For sure, in terms of special effects, he's an artist number one.
Dorota
and Arthur is a special case because their ideas like Time to Die or all psychological films they did, films that to a large extent relate to children. The title Speedway and action scenes for me is a special surprise, and I'm with great interest and tension I'm waiting for to see what they manage to do. I want to also present Mr. Kupczyk, who's the author of the piece of metal that stands in the middle of the stage. I'll tell you in a second what it's used for. I mean, I can imagine what it can be used for, or I can devise it from the lecture of the Film Pro materials. But now I'd like to invite my friends to take the floor.
Dzień dobry, dzień dobry.
Hello, hello.
Dzień dobry.
Ja może tylko na wstępie, bo potem chłopcy będą.
Just to start with, I'll say a few words. I will leave the rest to the boys. Yeah.
You hope that. Jak się z Kubą poznaliśmy.
Let me tell you how we get to know each other with Kuba, and it's good sometimes to watch the TV. I don't have a TV set for 25 years now, and we've been filming this, doing shots for Speedway in Wrocław.
I w hotelu.
And in a hotel. And in the hotel we had a TV set where we turned on, and it occurred that there is a trailer for the Uwaga program in TVN. And I saw a glimpse of Kuba, who was talking something about drones or something like that, and we watched that with Kuba. We watched the program with Kuba, and we decided to call Kuba and ask him and ask him for help and cooperation, and it That was that. It occurred that he's an incredible person and he makes crazy toys. Oh, come on. Arthur did not believe until the very end that the head will manage to make it through the filming for 2 weeks on the speedway track, you know, on the quad. But I believe everything went smooth as a dream, and I hope that next year we'll see the film together. And now I pass the floor to the guys. Dorota jumped over a lot of material because before we got there, before we got to Kuba, we started to call him the pineapple, and he had this like a special pineapple sock on his leg. This way was quite long. We did not have a lot to do with speedway ourselves, but it occurred that not only in Poland but all around the world, nobody made really a film about a speedway. There was one black and white film about speedway in England done after the war, and there was no support, and there were no reference how to start filming. We decided that we could do it that we can't do it in a classical Polish way. We started to call our crews and told them, listen, there's a film about the speedway. We started to have a Steadicam, the crane. Maybe we should need some head to do that. And they started to scratch their heads and said, it's impossible because they run too fast. You know, they have over 100 kilometers on curves. So all the equipment that we are using and that we know, tumble. They just fall on any sort of a curve. And so it all occurred to be not working at all. We started to think, and it's a very interesting point when you start to work on a material you've never touched upon before. And I felt a bit like in a film school myself. I started to work through that from the very beginning, how to start to think, you know. And after the consultations with the stuntman and the grip, we decided that this camera has to be as small as possible, so that the forces are as small as possible on the curve. We followed this route, this idea. We went along the route of a very small gimbal and a very small camera. So what you see here in front of you might be quite surprising because it's quite a big monster. But what we saw was we saw Kuba on TV and we got in touch with him, and he got really famous thanks to his small gimbals. Maybe you say a few words, maybe. I already told you yesterday during the panel that for years now we've been producing small gimbals, stabilizers for drones, and this is our main domain apart from the drones, which are our main product. We build small gimbals for small cameras up to 2 kilograms for those who work on the drones. As if somebody worked with a drone, well, those people know that droning are very difficult in camera stabilization and image stabilization and getting a very smooth moving image. So all this experience that we were collecting over the years in drones, we transferred that 1.5 years ago to a project of this huge stabilizer dedicated for cameras up to 25 kilograms. It is able to sustain, to manage even a better, a more weighty equipment. Even if you talk about gimbals, cameras such as gimbals such like Ronin, we can do twice as good in terms of weight of a camera. It means that you are the only ones in the world who produce such gimbals which can turn the camera like that. No, we're not the only ones in the world anymore. Let me come back to the fact, how did we get that big gimbal? And we decided to go for the small gimbal, and we wanted as small a gimbal as possible and as small camera. But Kuba calls me and says, listen, small gimbals are good, but I have something astonishing that you
you were really interested in. And it occurred that he has such a monster. And you know, my eyes got all shining because I understood that we can have our camera 6K put into this gimbal and we can record it on a big camera. And it occurred that, well, we agreed to have it in variants, to have the option. Kuba brought both of them. We agreed that maybe it will survive two days, maybe not one day, but after 2 days it will be in pieces. However, it occurred that the stabilizer arm fell apart, that bearings fell apart, but the head worked perfectly, even though that it was covered with 2 kilograms of mud. It worked perfectly until the end, you just had to clean it. In the hall you have this grandmother gimbal. Let me just show you. It was so that we wanted to get as close as possible to those drivers. Of course, you do have such equipment in the world. We do have this idea. That's where we come back to the idea of film spring open. But these elements are unattainable for them. Polish production has its limitations. There were claims that we have a high budget and the budget is too big. But even with the budget that we had, we could not, which is 7,300,000. We could not afford certain solutions. It's absolutely unrealistic if you want to get for a Polish production to get such equipment. That's why I got so excited that we have people like Kuba and who do such things in Poland. Because, you know, you can normally do business with such people. We can call Kuba and tell him, listen, we've got such and such situation, we do a film about Speedway, help us. And we were, with this project, we were in a key moment, because this... incredible coincidence Dorota spoke about,
mogli obejrzeć mnie w telewizji,
that they could see me on TV even though they do not have a TV set. It was a great luck for us because we really wanted to test this equipment in extreme situation because it was used for extreme situations. Just like Arthur and Dorota, I also had a lot of doubt and uncertainty in me that whether it's going to work, whether it's going to be fine. So both sides really wanted this cooperation to see whether it's going to work out. It might look slightly banal. We know all that from Hollywood production that such things are being made. However, I believe that this is an absolute top of the world which we've managed to achieve, that in Tarnów, in rural Poland, almost rural Poland, we had a vice champion, the second champion of Poland. Just getting this robust quad was very difficult because nothing on this track, apart from a speedway motor, nothing can attain such speed because it's impossible. You can cheat certain things, you can cut certain corners in a cinema. Unfortunately, on a speedway track, you might not cheat. For example, you might not show the slide of a motorcycle with a lower speed because it's just not going to work. We need to have at least 90 kilometers per hour on the curve. So it looked, you know, it looked pathetic otherwise. We thought about it in this way. We had to be able to move as fast as they do so that the filming looks right, they look right on the film, and that they look realistic. So that we could use this big camera in 6K, it allows us now in post-production. It's a huge post-production in here. As you can see, all those banners are black. They will be improved in post-production. They will be pseudo ads or pseudo elements on them after post-production. We had a 6K image for that, which is much better for any post-production studio than a small camera. That was one of the reasons. Of course, we parallelly to the shots that are being shown here, we made also shots on GoPro cameras. We fixed three cameras cameras on a small rig. And this material, I must tell you, this material is unusable. There is so much vibration, and the frequency is so high that whatever we got on the GoPro cameras, unfortunately, I didn't take this with me because it's very interesting to see. It's like abstract painting. You can't see anything. You've got just waves. But the sensor of the camera is too slow to get the image.
No nie, nie można tego było użyć.
So it was, unusable from the outset. We do have the footage, but it's not usable at all.
To co, może powiedz trochę więcej.
So maybe you could say a few more words about the big head, because I have a lot of stories about the Speedway, because it's one of the episodes we had to knock through a lot of doors and open a lot of ways to follow a lot of variants. It's one of the variants we're trying to follow. If you have questions, I will be happy to answer them, but maybe now we'll say a few words about the head. What you see here is a final production version of what we did. Right now we're doing a bigger production of those elements and we're trying to get to the market. What we've used half a year ago, when we started with those shots, this was a prototype. It was fully functional until today, operating, but in many areas different from what I'm showing you here on the stage. The main rule of operation, the mode of operation, is just a big gimbal. It does not differ from smaller gimbals. Yeah, we'll be just tossing in from one side to another.
Używamy tu teraz takiego dosyć prostego linku.
Just a small commentary, we're using a very simple HD link. This projector does not give us the best image, and the transmission makes it jerky a bit and quirky. Unfortunately. Well, there are three axes and four direct engines. It has its own HRS system. We have an absolutely ideal horizon regardless of speed, which was one of the problems in the very, very beginning of the shooting, because without the VHRS, we did not, the horizon was not very good, and we added it after 2 days. Yes, I'm a specialist now. This is what you see, this yellow lamp.
Kuba,
this is where it is.
Ja opowiem Kuba,
let me say a small anecdote. Kuba saw that this horizon is sort of moving, and so he said, it can't be like that. So he ordered from Asia. No, not from Asia. It was bought in Poland. We've managed to integrate quite easily the system. And we didn't expect the overload. For me, it was something new. And what you've seen a moment ago, this head had such a huge load that the G's was so high that it moved onto the side to 50-60 degrees. So a normal gyro did not work out. So added a compass and gyro element was a necessary move. Artur and Dorota mentioned yesterday
that
these shots are too ideal. They will be making them more quirky on the computer in post-production because they look unreal when the quad follows precedes the motors and it looks so stable. Coming back to the head, it was created for those heaviest and more complicated sets. The equipment that we've been using for the Speedway film, it was quite light. How much was it? 10? 12 kilograms? No, about 14 kilograms. Today we took the heaviest possible camera we have in the festival, in the workshops. We could have installed a small camera. Thanks to the guys from Axiom. I don't know how much does it weigh. It's about 10 kilograms, so it's still not an equipment which makes impression on the head itself. Just because we in our company use 25 kilogram piece of metal. We just put it in there. We film it and we see how stable it is. This is how we test it in our place. I don't know what to say more about that. Maybe you have some questions.
Słuchaj, nie wiem, no musisz ponegocjować z reżyserem.
You need
nie
to negotiate with the director.
Kawałek mogę pokazać?
I can show you a bit.
No, to będzie też okazja dla mnie,
this
żeby
is also be an opportunity for me to see a part of the film,
no,
because this
puścić,
is something no, that is not being
duża presja.
Shown. Yeah, you have to show just a bit. It's the pressure is so high.
To jest, poczekaj. Tutaj są fragmenty.
Here are fragments.
Ja może będę mówił. Zresztą zobaczycie, kiedy są fragmenty z głowicy.
Yeah, I'll be telling you where the fragments from the head will appear. Oh, you will see that anyway.
To jeszcze nie.
Not yet.
O, to jest fragment
here it is.
Z głowicy.
This is a fragment. This is a
także
fragment
widzicie,
from
jest,
the head.
No,
you can see that this camera is extremely stable.
It's
it matches
takim
perfectly
tak naprawdę.
Static
to jest kolejne ujęcie.
Material we have. This is another shot. Yeah,
to
it's
jeszcze
so
nie
clean.
Jest oryginalna prędkość.
It's not the original speed yet.
No to było też ujęcie z to też jest z
this
gimbala.
Is also from the gimbal.
Dobra, ja myślę, że jeden wyścig to wystarczy. Za sama zatrzymała.
Yeah, I think yeah, one
nie,
race is
tak,
enough.
Film jest w dużej postprodukcji i te materiały.
Yeah,
no,
the film is in a big post-production and this is not the film yet. It's not the fragment of a film. It's just a piece of a material at the stage of editing raw.
Pytania może macie jakieś, żebyś
maybe you have any questions? You have some questions so that we do not get into this super technological geeky way. Maybe you had a similar problem, have some similar experience.
To ja tylko jeszcze.
No to za to.
Ile setów było na planie?
How many sets there were on the? How many sets did you have on the?
No,
no, we had only one. You mean heads?
To było jedno, no, bo to
there
było
was
tak,
only one head.
Dwie,
we had two.
Była,
it was like you have the shots which we could also show you again.
Jakbyś przełączył. To jest kamera B, która filmowała.
This is camera B, which was filming from the side. So that's why we are seeing here the quad, because this is to be cropped, because it's a 6K material. In order to have a TV perspective, we were shooting with a B camera, this sort of setup, but we couldn't have made it differently on the track. We just needed one camera. During those shots, we have GoPro cameras installed. Your cameras were also tested by us. Unfortunately, those cameras had a problem that they were unusable because of distortion. The sensors did not manage the speed, and you know the frequency of the vibration is extremely high. We were using a black arm rig, and two bearings got broken. It was a new crane, and these bearings just broke in no time. You know the things that happened there. You can see that in the shots that we've made in, for example, in 600 frames. If you get to 600 frames, you can see what the vibrations are on the motorcycle. It's incomparable with driving on a street or outdoors, you know, in rough terrain, because the vibration is totally different in rough terrain, whereas on the speedway track, it's a different story. There will be onboard pictures too, but as I said, it's one part of the filming that we did in Wrocław. We filmed all that on green screen.
Ja nie wiem, czy w to wchodzić, bo to jest.
I don't know if I should get into that. It's very technological and I know in very highly technical discussion, and I don't know if you will be interested in that. There was a cyclorama developed there, which was built in such a way that the camera is static and the world moves around the camera. It's not like here with a crane of a movie bird, which is standing outside here. The crane of a movie bird is that it's moving to the left and to the right, and you can move this camera into any position in and Zbyk reversed this situation. He said, why should we turn the camera around? It cannot go 360% because you can't do it on a crane. And he turned the situation around, and everything what is in front of the camera turns around. So you can move this world 360 degrees. We went there, we went through some talks, we had some discussions, and I immediately started to see that it's ideal for the speedway because a guy sitting standing on the start line goes on, he takes a turn and it's 180 and then takes another turn and makes 360. So it allowed us to get a guy on the motorbike on this huge wheel, and without moving him we could have turned him and changed the perspective. So you have quite a lot of shots here where we have portraits, where we are very close in a portrait, and he's not moving in a portrait, he's getting through the 360-degree circle. I did not prepare that because we were talking about the head today and about Kuba, so it's a totally different topic. But every animatic had its own color, and every racer was moved on this track, and they will be then put together in a computer, and from there we'll take the portraits. Truth be told, to get close to them at such a speed would be too dangerous. Of course, we also have close-ups here.
Bardzo bliskie, gdzie widzimy oczy zawodnika.
Yes, maybe not extreme close-ups, because extreme close-ups will be from that studio. Can we move now to the camera, which is installed on the head?
Nie, no mów.
Jeszcze przypomniało mi się, że coś mogę wam powiedzieć więcej.
I remembered I can tell you something more about the head.
I może jakiś tam paru
and maybe about a few modes of operation and how we've worked, but this might be quite interesting to you. In general, we've used for this the wireless control and wireless transmission. We would not do that in a wired mode. We've worked in a paradoxically follow mode, which I will be talking about in a second. Right now it's in fixed stabilization mode, which is a mode which can always, wherever you, it always looks at one point. This movement of course here now you can see the change of the movement of the image, but it does not follow a point, it looks in one direction.
Bardzo często wykorzystywaliśmy w ujęciach tak zwany follow mode.
We were using the so-called follow mode.
Chcieliśmy uzyskać tak jakby wspomaganie naturalnego ruchu kładu,
support to the natural movement of the quad, which makes two U-turns.
Nie martwić się o to, że ja cały czas muszę myśleć o tym, żeby ten joystick był joysticka była przeze mnie.
Head is controlled through joystick by me.
Korygowana, więc ja tak naprawdę dzięki temu mogłem się skupić.
I was steering the joystick guy for 2 weeks. It was a great honor for me. I did something like that for the first time.
But I could, thanks to that, to the fact that the head followed the movement of the quad and
locked on those motors, I could more focus on the detail that Arthur and Dorota were shouting at me
through
my earphones. Get the yellow one.
This worked pretty well.
A very unusual application, because I believe I can imagine a situation where the follow mode, somewhere outdoors, off-road, where we do not have the same movement going in one direction, U-turn after U-turn, that could not work properly.
Oczywiście jeszcze do paru funkcji głowicy automatyczne funkcje
acceleration of the camera of the movement and others.
Wyłączyłeś teraz. Bateria się. Ciekawie jestem, co chcesz dodać.
I wonder what you want to
pewnie chciałbyś dodać
of
o tym, że na
probably
that
nie wszyscy wiedzą, not everybody knows what is gain or something. I was, I had the same story because Kuba between the shots he was running up to this camera and he was switching those things around. I don't know. You have to explain it to people because people do not understand your lingo.
Którą chciałem też jakby poruszyć, że my się bardzo dużo sami nauczyliśmy.
We learned ourselves a lot during the filming of the Speedway. We understood what people like you, the filmmakers, what you actually need from the equipment of this sort, because this is what this equipment was made for you. We wanted to create a tool which is to work in any possible conditions and should be non-problematic in setting up, in preparation for shooting, etc. Of course, in the beginning we had a lot of trouble with that, because for the first time we were installing such a big heavy camera for the first time, we had to get all those parameters in order. Today, all this is
tak przygotowaliśmy to po pół roku,
from the level
że
of controller, and after half a year, it is prepared to such a point that you do not have to be very proficient in terms of software, or even you do not have to read a very complicated instructions. You just on a few pages, you have information what you have to look out for, and very quickly you can then understand which of those levers and wheels are most important for you when you're changing the set of the location, for example. The conclusion is so: you should not be afraid. You should take risks when you're making films. You have to be bold and decide. Sometimes you make things for the first time, and they might be quite risky. It's also good to have a backup, the plan B, from which we thankfully did not have to use, thankfully, because the first variant was so good and so effective that we didn't have to follow the plan B. It is a good experience from my point of view. I always feel like a kid when we start starting a new film, and I'm always happy that we meet such people and as Kuba in our way. Also, Film Spring Open is so good in this that you can meet people. You meet people from different divisions. You can exchange information and experience and cross together things. You know, mix and blend things which would not get together in otherwise in life. I think we are the best example that it works perfectly well. We also had nothing to lose. We just built a head which in the worst case would fall apart. It did not fall apart, thankfully. But also we knew that we will have to test it in this way sooner or later. That's why we built this tool for maximal G's, for maximal loads, for the worst possible conditions. I was laughing in April that we've been doing this film for the whole year, because when we started in the beginning of May, it was snowing, and when we ended this film, it was over 30 degrees centigrade and the sun was shining, so we had a lot of trouble with the weather. I mean, a lot of surprises from the weather side. You know, horrible conditions on the track, mud, rain, snow, everything. From the point of view of
of builder of this equipment, that was the most important part. And cooperation with the crew was an incredible experience for me. Yeah, we can just sort of...
Synergia, to, że tam w zasadzie każdy chciał w jakiś sposób pomóc,
you know, the synergy that everybody tried to do their best. Of course, I'm not trying to get all the credit. There were plenty of people who was, like Mariusz, who was driving the quad, and all the time we could film that. Yes, Mariusz. Mariusz is a third element of in all this puzzle.
Szkoda, że go nie ma właściwie z nami.
Unfortunately, he's not here with us.
To nie udało.
Without him, we would not make it.
Mariusz, czyli kierowca kładu.
Mariusz, or the quad driver.
Zgodził się, no bo uznał,
Mariusz
że to
agreed because
zabawa.
He believed it's great fun. We met in a hotel.
Kłada,
he brought his quad.
No, we had planned
we planned the classical rigging. I don't know if you've built something like that. You build a floor, then you add some pipes to that, and this is what you do. But he came with his quad, and we can't do that, you know. Because can you once again show the film?
Podwozie jest miękkie.
Because
żeby się nie
the quad
nie
has
a
very, very fluid suspension, and the suspension is very low, and you cannot support anything under this. And this is where problems started. We knew that it's like 30 kilograms, which are 1 meter from the gravity center. We're moving to the side from gravity center. But Mariusz is an absolutely astounding guy. He said, no problem at all, I will do that. I will come up with what to do. I will buy right elements, right support. I will weld it and prepare it for the structure of my quad. And once we see the film, you will see how it was built by him.
No, okazało się to bardzo karkołomne.
It occurred to be very risky and very, it was very difficult. We made a number of structural mistakes when we were building that. We had to rebuild it a number of times.
Nikt nie wiedział, co to będzie.
Nobody knew
jechali
what will happen.
Z znakiem zapytania.
On Saturday, everybody came to the set with a huge question mark. Yeah, many things were improved by yourself, too. We saw during the filming what you can do better. Only when you start to do it in reality, you know, in real life, you can see what's happening. As you can, just to give you an image, just to give you an understanding, it was like 50 kilograms, the head with the camera, and it was off the gravity level. It was made as rigid as possible. Sometimes the quad was losing control with the track. I don't know if you can see that on the U-turns, the G's so high that he was really driving on the edge on two wheels out of four. He was driving on the edge of physical capabilities of his vehicle. If he were going 5 kilometers faster, he would tumble.
Na jego kładzie po prostu były łyse.
Yes, his
his
tires really were bled to the limit. You know, they were absolutely bare at the end of the shooting. So he really went to the edge. The battery, just to give you an understanding, you know, the quad even lost battery because of the vibration. The plates in the battery broke because of the vibration. So now you can imagine. Of course, it was quads battery. Usually, what he says, he takes part in races. He says that the loads are not so high as was during this film. Please ask questions. We all know that. These are all nice recollections from the set for us. So we can talk about that for hours. But maybe for hours, but maybe you have some questions. I understand nobody of you wants to make a film about Speedway.
Słuchajcie, nie wierzę.
Come on, I can't believe that.
Kuba, który jest konstruktorem tego urządzenia.
Kuba here, who's the creator of this equipment, and I had 150 questions to him. If you are a filmmaker, ask your questions.
Jaki jest zakres ogniskowy, który jest obsługiwany przez głowicę?
na żużlu testowaliśmy.
What is the range of focus?
50 było chyba najdłuższy. Że myśmy, ponieważ to było 6K, film będzie w 2K.
The film was made 6K, the film will be 2K, so we do have certain buffer. We allowed for some space so that it's not so precise.
Ale znaczy na pewno na 50 są ujęcia, które będą w filmie. Nie wiem, czy zakładaliśmy 85.
I think it was 50. I don't know if we did 85.
Ale odpowiadając na pytanie, bo to jest
the focal length, well, the 50, the F50 was at this vibration is really something. Of course, we know that in many shots, this long lens gives a totally different perspective. In our tests, we did shots in 200 f/250 millimeters, and the image is still very good. To be honest,
ja nie wiem, na ile
however, I do not
tym,
know how much it will be good in this case. To what extent it would be good in this case, because the G here was extreme, you know, the loads were very extreme, and we had to try this lens, and we had to try it. If on MovieBird you insert 300-305 millimeters, it's gonna work anyway. It's such a crane that it's gonna work without I would say seamlessly. Without the fourth axis which you can see here, without the equipment, without the fourth axis which is covered with a yellow cloth, green cloth, is necessary. It's absolutely necessary. Insulation from vibration is absolutely necessary in the shots like that. An additional arm which allows us to stabilize in all three axes, especially the zeta, which is up down on the vertical one, which just to get rid of all those of the unevenness of the surface of the track. The vibrations are so small that when you look at the image on the screen, it seems like they're like going like a knife on the butter, but the vibration is very, very high there. So the zeta axis, which allows the head to be stabilized at a certain level, is absolutely indispensable. As Arthur mentioned here, we used black arm here, which we got, which the crew got from England. Without that, I don't know if we would manage to do that.
Na biegu się.
Jeszcze wracając do tych, to jak mówiłem, myśmy nie mieli potrzeby takiej, żeby
because coming back to all this, we did not need to make portraits here, because Tomek Ziętek, who was playing the main rider here, we really wanted him to be under the helmet in those close-ups, so it was obvious for us that he would not go on the speedway motor, because it would be impossible. We made that in a different technology. The assumption here was that for some semi-close-up, we would not go closer than the semi-close-up in those shots. That was the assumption we've made.
Pytania.
Questions.
No dobra, to wam opowiem jeszcze.
All right, let me then, Kuba, have a rest a bit. I'll tell you also how did you work with close-ups. We followed the idea of Rybczyński, and we decided that we will install this motor on a computer rig. You know Kuka, you know it from Gravity. What are the names of those films? Because we are ambitious and we do it as Americans do in Hollywood, or even better than them. We decided to do that, and it occurred that everything was fine. The motor was installed on a rig, on the Kuka rig, but the Kuka robot was not able to mirror the vibrations on the track. We had certain shots on which we were sort of making our mock-ups, but once we tried to give it to set for the vibrations for the robot turned off. And after 2 days, we decided not to work with the robot anymore. Robot went home, and we had an idea to do it in motion capture.
po raz pierwszy zrobiliśmy to w filmie fabularnym w
Polsce. We did it for the first time in a feature film in Poland.
Którzy robili Wiedźmina.
Our friends from who made The Witcher helped us with that.
I no to się okazało to strasznie fajną, fascynującą to be a fascinating technology. Też będziemy w tym filmie używać.
Which we will also be using this film. This is the third element.
Pomoże nam w wypadkach na przykład.
Which helps us
wszystkie kraksy, które się dzieją,
in crashes, because we obviously we can't, we would not be able to do crashes in real life, because nobody wanted to take part in that, and nobody wanted to do it, and that would be, and that was done in motion capture. We were simulating the crashes. We were also filming the beginnings and the ends of the crashes in the room, like on indoors on the green screen, the beginning and at the end of the of an accident. But what happens in the middle of the accident, this can be done only on a computer, because you can't do it otherwise safely.
No tutaj wszyscy mieliśmy potwornego stracha, żeby
here
się
we were really,
wydarzyło.
Really scared that nothing would happen, but thankfully
odbyło się bez kraksy.
We've managed to pull it off without any crash. We had an ambulance every day with us on the set, because the risk was very, very high. When they're riding themselves, it's very risky, but when the quad is also on track, that for them was also a new thing. We had to learn everything from the very beginning.
I właściwie tak ten pierwszy dzień zdjęcia.
So the first day of shooting, do you remember, Kuba? It was sort of a try to feeling our way. If we thought that nothing would happen, nothing would work out during the first day of shooting. We all tried new things. Nobody did that. Mariusz never before rode with guys with motorcyclists. He did not see them. He did not have a mirror. They just agreed when they are going to take him over. It was quite difficult. It was also difficult when he was behind there and they were in front of him. They were going quite fast. They didn't see whether he's immediately behind them or they're losing him. They couldn't look back, because that would spoil the shot. So it looks very simple, but in
dużym wrażeniem, przyznam szczerze, bo
I was also under a very good, very big impression, because it was my first time on the real filming set. How you prepared those riders before every shot, because communication on the track was very bumpy, but you could not improve that. It was noisy all the time. It was, have you ever been, if you've ever been to a speedway race, you can imagine what was happening. Yes, once they start their motors, you cannot communicate with them anymore. So in order to show them anything on a screen and tell them try to get closer or try this way or that way, you would have to stop the whole race and make everybody turn off the engines. It was for the guys also a great challenge. It seems that once you show them go this way and then change this way and now you overtake him and etc., that would be extremely difficult. If you talk for 3 minutes more, I will try to find it. I will show you animatics, but I think I do have them here. What you can see here, it's a part of animatics which was very well planned. This was the most difficult part, that on the curve they will get into this formation and that one thing happens and not something else. Because if another guy, if a guy didn't get into place, the whole shot was spoiled and we had to redo it. That's why they quite often get very slowly into this curve, because they are building formation so that they have, let's say, they have a maximum speed when they're leaving the curve.
Arthur,
you can look for it, but it's not like for those 2 weeks we were doing one shot. Could you turn it off for a while?
Because I
don't want to show you my private pictures.
To było tak, Dorota może mnie wspomóc, że przez każdego dnia tych ujęć było
zaplanowanych
ileś konkretnych
of shots planned for every day with guys in different helmets. I remember there was green, yellow, blue, because it was important whom are we filming on one day or another. And we were here in quite exceptionally. We got a mature group of riders of racers, because because when we started our shooting, not on the track, but the guys were to drive around in Rzeszów, and we said, listen, you, after the start, you have to be the second, you have to be the third, and at the end, the white one has to be the first one, and the blue one has to be the last one. The guys were saying, yes, of course, and of course, during the filming, they started to get into a real race, because it's dishonorable for them to be the last. Not to mention that they're used to, because you know, all the four circles is 1 minute. There are 15 runs in a match, so they run. They're all running. The whole team is running 15 minutes during a match. They during a race, they have trainings for 1.2 to 2 hours. So after one hour of shooting, the guy said, okay, it's time to go home. So really, you had to talk to them, you know, convince them quite a lot. The guys in Rzeszów were younger than those internów, that we had to tell them that it's not the way you work with when filming in the film industry. You have to work for 12 hours and there's no possibility to work other way. So, and there was this, you know, there was this guy who was lying next to the camera on the ground, and he said, man, why are you lying here? Is it like a penalty for you? Or, and he did not believe that somebody could consider this to be rewarding. Here the choreography was very well prepared. Oh yes, I've managed to get one shot. Of course, every shot is rendered individually, but you will see how this small fragment, the small element works, and what we were fighting for, what we were struggling for. This is the fragment. This is the speed with which they go, and this is after the shot. So if we're working with this, when working with the quad, we were struggling to get things like that. This is how it's gonna. It has to work. We have about 20-30 shots like that, and this is what it looked like in practice. We were showing them, listen, this is how you're gonna drive. This choreography, the whole race was being made in the animatics. We knew how they're gonna behave after the start. Are you getting dizzy? Well, it's all right, but you can see the speed that we were looking for.
Pytania.
Jak nie macie questions. Pytań, to kończymy. If you have no questions, that's the end of the lecture.
Piąta oś, którą oś masz na myśli?
Fifth axis.
No właśnie tłumaczyłem.
Which axis? Momentem, że to I told you a moment ago that it was the stabilizing black arm.
W dużym skrócie, to wygląda troszeczkę jak amortyzator.
It looks a bit, it looks a bit like a dumper in a car. It's like a big spring.
Amortyzatorowe.
Like a big damper spring.
Połączenie wahacza ze sprężyną i amortyzatorem.
Yes, it's like, yeah.
Czyli
like in a car, like in a vehicle.
I ono działało tylko i wyłącznie na zasadzie fizyki.
And it worked just on the basis of physics. It's compensated with a spring, you know, with the weight of the camera, cause
tak,
the arm
nie dawało tego impaktu bezpośrednio na mechanikę,
switch,
tylko pozwalało się głowicy
set this, put this impact
tak,
on the mechanics, but allowed the
pojawiały się jakieś bounce na samym obrazie
głowicy. Setback to the camera, but so if there was any bounce
leniwe,
from the camera,
tak?
They were very, very, very slow.
To by było,
if we
tak,
made it rigid, this
bardzo szybko przemieszczała w przestrzeni,
head would move in space very quickly.
Nie stabilizuje nam przemieszczenia w przestrzeni.
This does not. It was not correcting our stabilization in the space, but on the axis, which is a very important difference. But you've seen that in the shots we've made for the film, that it goes smooth, really smooth. We'll be probably trying to spoil it in post-production because it looks too good.
Fajnie.
That's good. I love to hear that. So.
Kończymy, no nie ma co.
Okay. Chcesz coś tutaj kopnąć twoją głowicę, żeby
można ją kopnąć.
Do you want to do something with your I can I do you want to kick your head for her to do something. I'll kick the dolly just to show you the power of the engines that we're using. The motors that we're using.
Ten wózek razem z tymi madłem to jest 30 parę kilo na dole, więc
this dolly together with this part is 30 kilograms and this engine works without problem to correct the position here.
Łączna siła, którą the total, te silniki generują, to jest mniej więcej 120 kg na centymetr.
The total strength of the engines is 120 kg per centimeter, so it's quite a lot. If we combine them to, in one axis, well, we could be able to lift you on a centimeter. If somebody works with gimbals and probably you use the gimbals in your films, it's very, there's always a problem with balancing your gimbal. And usually this camera is too heavy. We did have always a Ronin DJI, and when you put a red on the Ronin, the engines start to squeak because they did not could not manage such a load. And for me, it was also a very nice surprise that you don't only have such a nice gimbal, but you have something like this. I will answer one. You can kick it and nothing will happen. I will answer one more question. It's 100% designed by us, including the engines. You cannot buy those engines. We had to cut them out. We had to build them all. Everything aluminium from the very basics is built in solid works in our company. We cut it and do it. It's good that you have this camera here because.
Także ktokolwiek by chciał się pobawić przy jakimś
projekcie, to want to play with this equipment in any project, we're open for cooperation and you're invited to talk to me and as well with Artur and Dorota, I believe.
Wiecie co, powiem wam szczerze, że
to be quite honest
oczywiście
with you,
rozważamy wszystkie opcje, rental
taking into account all the potential options including rental.
Trudno mi jest jeszcze mówić o cenach, bo tak talk about prices, wchodzimy dopiero
because
w ten,
we're just
w ten
sort of feeling this market of serious cinema and we're still thinking
po prostu nad cenami, no.
About pricing.
Ale będziemy sprzęt chcieli i wynajmować, i sprzedawać.
We would want to rent
prostu,
it and we would want to sell it.
I jak tylko będziemy mieli już
and
konkretny
once we have
cennik,
some concrete price sheet, we will publish it and while whereas if you're interested in this right now, just write uavrobo.com in your browser and we'll talk to us and we'll respond. It's not an accident that we are here with Kuba. It's something that could be well working in Hollywood. But if you call Kuba and you tell him what the problem is about, and this is my advice to you, that if you have any, the need to use this equipment, call Kuba. And I believe that it's going to work. Yes, we're open to cooperation. We've created this equipment for you. We are still in the beginning of the road. There are plenty of we still have plenty to do, and there's a room for development. So we're ready for cooperation. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming over.